that's best.
So, so obviously, we were hearing a lot of reports from mayors of the cities that I'm connected with, from law enforcement of the cities, that, you know, it was coming this way, and we needed to be prepared. And then we got the, it seemed to be a firm date that people were coming to town around the country. This was the place, Savannah was going to be where it was going to happen. And again, we are a walking city. We're a city that has a lot of storefronts and those types of things. And you know, so obviously it was very concerning. We also didn't want our citizens or our law enforcement to die. And we did not want this to turn into a us versus them battle. We decided to take advantage of the opportunity, and instead of running from it, to face ahead of it. So essentially, we co-opted the event and wanted to help the young people that are organizing it to have it, but people to imagine in such a way in which they were able to get their message across, but we were able to keep people safe. And so from that, I've been introduced informally to various young people that I wasn't really sure I knew about different people. Every time I turned, I was a different organizer. And again, so that was extremely concerning. So we didn't know really who we were really dealing with. And it was, again, concerning because there were people from other cities, again, that we knew were saying things about coming to Savannah. So we knew we were dealing with two different events, the peaceful side of it, and then after the observance. So for us, it was a matter of, again, making sure on Saturday night I decided to do a press conference. And I want to make it absolutely clear to people who are trying to come to our city that the violence is not welcome in Savannah. The damage is not welcome in Savannah. If they want to come and express their First Amendment right, we welcome them to do that. We're